one of the holiest gatherings in the world this year, the Mahakumbh in Allahabad on the banks of the Ganga, one that is expected to play host to almost 100 million pilgrims from all over India and overseas. Not surprisingly, it's becoming a melting pot for brands across categories, jostling for visibility, branding opportunities and even to make a sale. Leading the brand wagon at the Mahakumbh are telecom brands. Vodafone has put up stalls offering Vodafone branded earmuffs for pilgrims to beat the chill, besides putting up a special cinema hall showcasing devotional movies.
70 million people are expected to move around in the Kumbh area in a matter of alone 45 days. So this kind of volume of people at one go, nowhere else you will get an opportunity to connect with so many people at one go.
Another telecom joint idea can be seen splashed across branded gates, buses, boats and even maps. It has also launched special recharge coupons across 500 retail counters, akharas and ashrams, and has also installed over 100 PCO booths to provide telephony services to the pilgrims.
It's a great opportunity for us to build visibility, brand salience, because the footfalls are very high, and of course boost sales.
These chapatis have been stamped with a message, like Poise Haath Dhoya Kya, a fabulous way for the soap brand to brand itself at the right place and at the right time.
For our brand, where we're spreading a message of hygiene, 100 million people in close proximity really offers us an opportunity to do what we want to do. I think there is a power. If you're going to be in a place like the Kumbh with 100 million, you have to have an idea that cuts through.
It's creating new media. And you know, you never thought of chapati as a medium. You know, you always thought of it as food. But when food becomes a medium and the medium is so relevant to the message, I think it's one of the best sort of ideas going around.
Lifebuoy has also tied up with over 100 dhabas and hotels at the Kumbh to serve at least 2.5 million chapatis this month. Dabur, for which 50% of the business comes from rural areas, has been aggressively promoting Dabur Amla Hair Oil, Dal Dant Manjan and Odomos by running mobile branded vans, offering head massages and distributing sachets to connect with potential consumers.
Women folk in rural who are largely confined to the villages get a large opportunity for participating in occasions like this. And it enables companies to connect with them in a very big way. So it's also a time when the population has a larger amount of disposable income post-harvest in their hands. So the mood is celebratory and there is income in the hands of people to spend.
Amul, which has a 2.5 crore consumer base in rural markets, has put up 26 booths at the Mela ground apart from special Amul parlors.
The Mela, which manifests itself into a battleground for brands, has also been getting good revenues for them. For instance, FMCG companies are notching anywhere between 10 to 15,000 of sales per day, while cola companies are recording up to 18,000 of sales per day per stall. So you can well imagine the kind of monies that brands would be making if they were present there for the entire month. But despite that, experts warn against taking the event purely for sales.